More children are deserting the government schools and going to private
Absolutely.
schools. Even the teachers of government teachers are going to private schools. They're not going to government
schools.
And we are acting as if it's a non-problem. And, you know, we have 14 regulations and all. I think we should get out of this hypocrisy.
Yeah, I think instead of calling it a problem, I mean, everywhere I go, people talk about the problem. It's a sign of government failure. Why don't we celebrate? I think India could be at the, you know, the lead for this entrepreneurial education solutions to help the poor. It's already at the lead there just by freeing up some of the regulations. Yeah. You can really revolutionize education for the poor.
I feel we can't get away from the government's role. The government is vast. It has the infrastructure.
And
it has
the money.
Reach. And why can't we look at the way in which, you know, teachers are trained, the basic requirements, and address that? I think we're getting away from that.
I don't think we can get the reach by just talking of private schools. Hold government accountable for the money they spend on primary education and their social obligations to make people literate.
The pressure is building, Nandan, isn't it?
No, but the thing is, what's going to happen is, the pressure comes when the people go to the schools. When people can go to private schools, anybody who can afford it will get out of the system.
Absolutely.
And then the only people left in the public school system are those who have no money and no authority. And they will never improve.
Now, you should be able to create an urban common school system where private schools actually take over management, or private institutions take over management, and that can run. Even in the rural areas, I was in Bihar in one village, and the community basically told me, the leader of the community, Ram Pyare Singh, told me, we've constructed this school since 2003 with SSA money. It was a beautiful school, very well constructed, standard SSA design, but it was obvious that they had taken care. The only government teacher appointed there was one head teacher, but this was a 1 to 8th school. And they said, all other teachers are volunteers from the village. I was shocked. I said, it can't be. But that was the record. They said, we don't want the government teachers. I said, shall I go and tell the Patna people, please don't do that. Told the Bihar government, why don't you give them a per child grant to run the school? This is how community schools were once upon a time.
So if you have some form of per capita grant coming to schools, we did this in England. We tried this in England for a while, and we're still doing it. It works. The schools then become aware if children are leaving, and the schools suffer as a result. It's a small step, but it's a refusal, I think, public to acknowledge the problem in government education. That's part of the problem. Privately, people are very upfront. You know, I'm an outsider. I had a senior official, I won't mention his name, but a senior official in the national government told me there's not one single parent in India today who sends his children to a government school by choice. Told me that frankly.
That is true. Given a choice, children, parents would send the children to a better school.
Yeah, absolutely.
But the definition of a better school, and I have some disagreement with your whatever findings or projections. We find when we looked at the results on the private and the government school, if you control for certain factors, in some states the private schools are better. And in some states, the private schools are not necessarily better than the government schools because the government schools are getting better. Let us not say that the government school teachers cannot perform. Because then you are saying that this whole human capital investment that we've done for so many years and we'll continue to do, you're not going to throw all these teachers out of jobs. It's not possible. How to make them productive is an important question before us.
And I think it's also got to do with local self-government. You see, I think the best way to make these schools more effective is if the school administration is under the leadership of the panchayat. Because they know what they want and they will make sure they teach accountable. Because of the fact that our villages and cities have got dysfunctional, all the teachers are part of the school state bureaucracy. And they don't care two hoots whether the village panchayat looks at them or not. And they can disappear for months and nobody's bothered. So I think placing these schools under the direct local management is a very integral part of the solution.
The point I was trying to raise earlier is that the government is well aware, one, there is a fallacy that, you know, they actually they've got schools on the basis of distance, not on the basis of population. So the whole student-teacher ratio is getting completely skewed. In a more populated area, in a more populated village, you've got 50 students to one teacher. In lesser populated areas, the ratio comes down. Secondly, teachers, and you know, we did a campaign through the Hindustan Times, and we found in many, many villages, teachers are actually subcontracting their jobs to the so-called sahayaks or the para-teachers, who are actually getting 2,000 rupees or 3,000 rupees. So typically a teacher gets somewhere between 8 to 10,000 rupees. You take that salary, you subcontract it, and you're out doing other things. And this is happening right under the nose of the local authorities, but they don't care. So getting back to what Nandan said, that if the panchayats have greater say, you won't have this sort of a situation.
to move away from subcontraction, I'm going to get everybody to give us their final comments in terms of what, you, to your mind, are the big ideas really to solve the problem in our classrooms. Madhav, I'm going to start with you.
I think government-funded, locally managed school is what my final solution is. Locally managed is a choice of what, but it should be one school.
Okay.
It can be one school, because otherwise one school as in multiple competing schools, competition is good in markets and stuff, but the social division worries me. The second part is, I think government has to recede, decentralization is required, and apart from these kinds of private entrepreneurial things, there is a lot of nation building effort that has to go into the schooling.
To me, that the obvious thing is to go with the grain of parental choice, say they prefer these private schools, let's see if we can allow these schools to improve, deregulate them so that they can improve, maybe bring in some scholarship scheme to allow the poorest of the poor to attend these schools, and encourage entrepreneurs, investors and others into this space, because once you've got one or two investors bringing higher quality education into this space, competition will see that it spreads. And
Shobna?
Two things. I think the private sector definitely needs to be encouraged in terms of removing some of the regulatory issues which are there. I also think that perhaps something in the form of a tax break, if one were to get into education, is something that the government ought to look at to encourage the private sector. And therefore, they've got the enrollments, they've got the numbers, they have to look at infrastructure now, and they have to look at the quality of teaching, minimum requirements for teachers, infrastructure.
Nandan?
I think leave ideology at the door, give the private schools full freedom, improve the public schools, and get every child educated as soon as possible.
Well, freedom and autonomy, we leave you with those ideas to think about. We'll join you again next week. My many thanks to all of you for joining us here on this special discussion. Catch Imagining India with Nandan Nilekani next week. Till then, for more of us here, goodbye, and thanks very much for watching.